Hello and welcome to Understanding Narcissists. Thank you so much for joining me. In this episode, I want to talk about the damage a narcissist does to you and or has done to you. And just for the sake of it, trying to assess it, trying to understand it from the point of view and with the intention of healing it, helping it, improving it, and relieving that pain and that damage without becoming overly concerned, obsessive, or wallowing in it, getting caught up in it. Because that's the nature of narcissists, is a lot of wasted time, wasted effort, wasted emotion and fear devoted to something that never actually materializes or happens, just again and again. Getting off of the wire, living on the wire, which is what they do to you, the position they put you in, is to always have negative emotions and negative associations with things that really don't warrant it whatsoever. Hence, wasted time. But wasted time does not do it justice in explaining just how destructive it is. The damage a narcissist does to you, the harm they inflict, is not, for the most part, cosmetic. It's not something that most people will see. A trained professional, perhaps, and people close to you can see it, can see the changes in your behavior. And it's such a difficult thing to understand. In the first place, because few people will see it and recognize it. And that's probably half the issue right there. Because if you can't see it and you can't recognize it, you can't tangle with it for what it is. Because you really do have to grapple with these problems. You're always grappling. Most of that confusion is because it is not identified properly, in my opinion. And you may be familiar or have experienced, as I have, that there's somehow this concept, even nowadays, that if you undergo a lot of emotional abuse or trauma, somehow when you get away from it, things should mostly be okay. Even if it was going on for years or decades, somehow that pressure's relieved, so most of that pain should be resolved or have subsided by now, and you should be able to get your life together or collect whatever, kind of work it out, work through it. I think that idea is sort of fading now because it's kind of nonsense. It just doesn't work that way. I don't have any ideological belief that would lead me to reach that conclusion that all that stuff is nonsense. I kind of agree that you need to move on, you need to move forward, and all that kind of stuff, but it's pretty vague. And that doesn't necessarily mean this superficial getting your life back together, getting a job, moving, whatever, and having things together, at least in a material sense. And yes, I like that. But the problem is that's also what the narcissist would have you do. It's still playing into that paradigm where the emotions aren't really that big of a deal. You'll work through them, they're fluid, or they're really hard to define, doesn't really matter. As long as you look good, right, while you're doing all your things, you're gainfully employed, whatever. The problem is all the twists and turns that the narcissist really implanted in you still going on. And you will experience it. You will know exactly what I'm talking about, even if other people do not, even if onlookers do not, and even family. And it's worthy noting that sometimes family can be invested in the narcissist's illusion, and that's why there can be problems with them understanding your issues. Because there's, narcissists have tendrils everywhere. Even if they don't like the narcissist, there's still something where they're able to manipulate everyone's perceptions. Even people who don't like the narcissist and don't fall for their games, most of the time, when they're able to resist it, they still don't see the narcissist as the monster that they really are and can be. And that's really unfortunate because it makes it impossible to really get allies on your side when you're trying to heal, who will improve your life in the same direction that you're going. You see what I'm saying? So that they're aligned with you and are informed and can give you insight. Because most of the time, I find they can't because they don't understand the narcissist. Because, and this is probably where I could get a little controversial, I don't think they understand the emotional underpinnings and what's going on in our heads. The narcissist reveals that there's so much with the human mind that we don't understand. It's not just a select group of people. They're able to manipulate everybody. There's these emotional layers and underpinnings that we can't define or formulate as of yet. And it's really hard to trace the amount of damage they do and cause you, and really what the total amount of the damage is at the end of it. Because there really isn't an end of it. There's things you have to deal with for the rest of your life. And they exploit things. They don't necessarily create it outright, but they recognize what your weaknesses are and they get in there and they make you feel so bad. Right? It's mostly not cosmetic. Most narcissists aren't, from what I can tell, hitting people all that much. Yes, there's verbal abuse, however that relates to emotional abuse, but the emotional abuse that's going on and how it changes you and conditions you to behaviors that are destructive. And it's so hard to trace because it's traumatizing and there are bad associations. You know, certain activities you won't do anymore because they make you feel so bad, or you fear. You're so fearful, you're so scared. And it can be as simple as the narcissist attacked you emotionally as soon as you did those things, as soon as you got anywhere near something that they perceived as a threat and thought would hurt them. But it's also like there's these seeds in you that are working that the narcissist is responsible for, but they don't necessarily control the entire direction and thrust of the damage that those things cause. That sounds really vague. So what am I talking about? Well, it seems like whatever they implant in you continues to work without them having to tend to it. And even when you've left them, that's still going on and you have to deal with it. So a very insidious thing. And the most insidious part and the most dangerous part is that it's so hard to get a hold of and put your finger on. And yet, it'll destroy you all the more because of it, right? You can't define it. And early on, even when you get away, you can't necessarily or may not be able to necessarily conceive of it and recognize that it exists, but you just feel bad, really bad. And a lot of this is illusion within itself. It sort of takes the form of like emotional self-destruction. And it kind of presents itself as an obsessive quality and behavior that you've taken on where you're overly concerned with who you are as a person and what's wrong with you. And if you're a narcissist and all these other things, sort of the ends of the narcissist accusations towards you. You know, as soon as you try to put a label on something and set everything straight in your head, the narcissist would scramble it all again, right? Especially when you start to figure out that they're the bad person, they're the abuser. The first thing they do is flip it back onto you that you're doing something wrong. And that works sometimes for a very, very long time, but it can't work forever because, you know, there's a pattern going on and you have to admit to yourself at some point, the only thing that isn't changing when this pattern is unchanging is the narcissist. Therefore, the narcissist has to be responsible for it because no matter what you do, nothing changes. But you still have that lingering insecurity and terrible fear that there's something wrong with you and that you're broken somehow. And that carries on forever in little things. It's those little things throughout your day that you can feel happy, and then all of a sudden you feel terrible because there's some kind of trigger. There's something that brings back this rush of real, I don't want to call it self-hatred, though it certainly is related to that. But it's this perception of what will happen if there is something terribly wrong with you that you can't fix. And that's really what at the heart of everything. That's what the problem is you. And that's how the narcissist sits with you for so long, for so many years. They're able to remain destructive in your life through that really implant, that force. And as it really continually exploits you, it doesn't get worse, but it sure feels like it gets worse. And it doesn't feel like it subsides. And that kind of thing is the poison and the actual enemy that you have to identify. Because I can sit here and personify the narcissist and give you visual exercises or whatever so you feel better right now. But it's the damage from your own fear of believing that there's something wrong with you. Not actually your belief in it. Because that's not really you. You don't really believe that. Someone imposed that on you and you're taking it on as your own self-concept and directive, but it's really not yours at all. Somebody had to give that to you. And that's certainly something I had to deal with for a very long time, believing that I was a person that I really wasn't, because other people, particularly narcissists, saw me that way and insisted in so subtle ways and not so subtle ways that I was that person. And I started to realize that it was just false. But it's not a simple thing, and it doesn't just happen overnight with a snap of your fingers. And I think, as I say, half the battle is kind of recognizing it when it's going on and proceeding anyway with things you're going to do, because it's going to turn you away from all kinds of things that you want to do and that make you happy, with the fear of looking stupid or feeling stupid. But it's not just insecurity, it's a lack of self-confidence, it's this self-worth that somehow you're different from everybody else and you're broken. And I think everybody can relate to that, even people who haven't been abused by narcissists, just any emotional abuse that constantly calls into question your self-worth and gets you into a pattern of behavior, an emotional pattern where you're always prone to falling into that for whatever reason, from whatever triggers that were sort of installed in you and that you're really vulnerable to. And I don't know what this video is supposed to achieve, except maybe highlight that portion of the narcissist abuse, because it's really the most important thing. It's what's going on with you. I can sit here and talk about narcissists all day, but it does get tiresome because you're just talking about really dysfunctional people. And it helps when it helps you recover. But think about, without obsessing over, oh, there's this thing wrong with me. Really accept from the outset that it's not your fault and there really isn't anything wrong with you in that way. And I don't want to go into that. The reasons for that in this video as to why you can't be a narcissist. Because you can't be, in my opinion. But what you can do to abate and avert that feeling and look at it from a third-person perspective, because it's really not you, and it's not something you should have to grapple with every single day. It is a problem, but it's not your problem. You have real problems. This is distracting you from real problems and compounding over time, making you think increasingly that you can't handle anything, which is just false. So instead of getting caught up in what's supposedly wrong with you, start thinking about, as I'm sure you have, it's not to lecture you, but start thinking about what things allow mean people to get into your life so that you start thinking about what's wrong with you. And take it from there, and take it for what it's worth, for whatever it's worth. So I hope you like this video. Like it if you do. Share it with somebody you think might benefit from it and also like it. And comment in the comment section below about your experience with this matter and tell me if this has any relevance to you and if this problem has caused a lot of pain and destruction in your life and how you're overcoming it and how you think others might be able to benefit from your methods as well. Thank you so much for watching. Subscribe to the channel if you haven't already, and I will see you in the next episode. I hope you have a wonderful day. Bye.